make no less than 6 PB&Js every day in our house. So jam is something we go through, and it's pretty easy to make, and it's a good use of all those peaches. And this one is now asking for sandwiches. This is the last jar of peach jam, cooked peach jam I made. So it's time to make some more. Hopefully I can show you. I don't think I'll get it done in one day, because when you cook without pectin, you have to cook for hours. Hours. So step one is clean the kitchen. Check. Okay, I picked the peaches yesterday. Check. All right. Let's see what we can get done. This is the texture it looks like after it's been processed, cooked, processed, and then it's cold right now. So I think that's pretty good. It's kind of thick, but it still spreads. So we have pitted and actually more like eighths these, and I changed my mind. We're gonna save these to eat for fresh eating, so I don't have to drive 8 miles to my dad's house today to get more for fresh eating. So I want this pot full of peaches. So let's go get some out. My dad does all this work. Pretty much one hand. He does all that. And then they have a freezer at their house now, but still I have a bigger freezer. Mostly, once again, we have a freezer full of fruit and a little bit of rabbit and a little bit of that. That's you don't need to see that. That's coffee. We still have more fruit and coffee grounds. Oh, ah, oh, stop it. So let's get some peaches. Sugar is peaches. We're not going to do that. Let's see here. A quarter cup of lemon juice. We're not doing pectin. Okay, so we don't measure. We don't measure. This just keeps with the color and boosts the acidity. Peaches, high acid food, no pressure canning. Shall we assemble the machine? Need just a little bit of oil on this piece. Thank you. So we've got frozen and fresh, and then we're just gonna steam them and get them soft, and then we will stick them in our food mill. How long do you need to steam the peaches? Just until they're soft. And if you're like my dad, that means you take the peaches off the ground after they fall. You don't take any off the tree. You wait till perfectly ripe that they fall on the ground and get fruit. If you're like me, and if you're like my dad, then that means you don't want to steam them at all. But if you're like me, you don't like to use raw fruit. So you grab a peach, and if it kind of like goes, we're out of propane there for a second. All right. We are boiling, and all that foam you could skim off. I'm also worried about it going over, boiling over as it gets hotter and hotter. My grandma taught me this the very first time I made jam. She taught me everything. She was my start to canning. Oh, there's a bee. You add some butter and it helps. Whoop! You see that? I almost burned myself. Anyways, I just added vegan butter. I'm having some sensitivity right now. And that helps so that the foam doesn't just keep going and going over. Kind of just like in pasta, you add a little bit of oil to the top and it helps calm down. Oh my gosh, we're gonna make a big old mess. We gotta turn this down. It is 7:58 and I'm still boiling jam. Can you believe it? I've been going at it all day. Just kidding.
Just kidding. I had to stop around 4 o'clock because we had to do an emergency run to Grandpa's house so that he could make my son's rocket, help him make his rocket for Scouts tonight, because I don't like dealing with that. They always blow up because I glue them wrong, and so I just didn't want to do that. So emergency call to Grandpa, he came through, and then we went to the store because we needed sugar, and then we needed salt and milk and potatoes and apples. So yeah, that added up too. And then we went to Scouts, and then we put the kids to bed. And then, so I've been working on cleaning up the kitchen. See that stack of dishes? Oh yeah, that's some good dishes. So here we are, it's starting to thicken up quite a bit. It's almost to the point where it's pretty dangerous to stir it, because you scrape the bottom and it goes like that. It's almost like candy making. If you've ever made candy and you have to get to the hard, soft, rock, I don't know, stages. So, let's test our jam. Here we have a plate that was in the freezer. Have you seen the price of real vanilla? Babies and kids are all in bed, husband's in bed. Don't set off the smoke alarm, please. They're all out of the hot tub. Here, 13 of these, and one little half baby that I'm experimenting. I've seen people just turn it upside down and it'll seal. We'll see what that does. Okay, it's 9:30 and I'm too tired to try and do the math of how many cups of sugar I did with that. And my mind is kind of fuzzy, but I didn't use pectin because I didn't want to buy pectin. But the kids are eating pancakes or waffles and enjoying some sweet, sweet peach jam.